To use the relief fill feature, you need to start with a grayscale bitmap. When the relief fill is applied, toolpath operations will be calculated according to the darkness levels within the bitmap. The darkest portions in the bitmap will be the deepest cuts, and the lightest portions will be shallow. In other words, white will be the surface of the loaded material, black will have the greatest depth, and shades of gray between white and black will vary in depth. The result will be a three-dimensional machined piece where the gradients of the bitmap will become smooth slopes and contours. For the examples presented here, we use the contour fill tool to convert vector text into a grayscale bitmap. Alternatively, you could import a grayscale bitmap. Or if you import an STL file, which is commonly used in 3D modeling, then the import will create a grayscale bitmap. For a selected bitmap, go to the Engrave menu, then Create Toolpath, and then choose Relief Fill. In the Relief Fill dialog, we begin by specifying the maximum depth that can occur. As said, this will be the depth applied for black portions of the bitmap. Unless you have a special requirement, the minimum depth will be the surface of the loaded material. After setting the tool, the choice of fill style will depend upon what you feel is most efficient for the job. Note that two tools can be set, where the first tool will hog out material, and the second tool, referred to here as the fine tool, will be a cleanup pass. As you see here, we are not using a fine tool. Instead, we have set a slight overlap to remove stray material. In comparison, our second bitmap has a relief fill operation that uses two tools. The choice of tool, and whether a fine tool is needed for cleanup, will depend upon what you feel will produce the best results for the given job. When a fine tool is enabled, we have two options available: sweep all and ignore background. For the sweep all option, this will cause the fine tool to traverse the entirety of the area that was hogged out by the main tool. For the ignore background option, we refer to the background as being the black portions of the bitmap. So if we ignore the background, this will cause the fine tool to traverse only the non-black portions of the bitmap. In other words, ignoring the background will require less job time, which is okay if you believe that the main tool has done a sufficient job of removing material. At this point, note that we define Z0 as being where the tool bit is set flush with the surface of the loaded material, which we would do when loading the fine tool into the bit holder. Z0 is not in this dialog. It is commonly understood that, when loading a tool bit, the tip needs to be zeroed out at the surface of the loaded material, and tooling operations will plunge into the material from that point. If your machine can automatically set Z0 to the material surface, then the setting will be precise, and it will probably be safe to choose the Ignore Background option. However, for machines where you manually set Z0, there is a greater chance that you are slightly off, which will cause a slight ridge when using the Ignore Background setting. To avoid a ridge, use the Sweep All option, so that the fine tool will uniformly clean the entire surface. If we were to ignore the black background, then what remains will be the principal object, which in this case is some text lettering. When the fine tool has been set to ignore the black background, then the tool will be constrained by the edges of the object. If you want the fine tool to perform operations that include an offset from the object, then set the object offset field accordingly. Finally, for the vector shape resolution drop list, there are three settings: standard, high, and best. Your choice here depends upon the level of quality that you feel is necessary in order to obtain satisfactory output. Generally, the standard setting will be okay. If you choose a higher quality, then please note that this will increase the time required for calculating the toolpath operations. After we click OK to create the relief fill toolpaths, we can use the View menu, Show 3D, to preview the result. And seen here is the result of machining some signboard material. The top example is the result when we used a single tool. The bottom example is the result when we include a fine tool. Compare these on-screen previews with the result of having output the job.